आफ्टर महात्मा गांधी लॉन्च हिज फ्री सत्याग्रह वन इन चंपारण खेदा एंड अहमदाबाद गांधी जी इन 1919 डिसाइडेड टू लॉन्च ए नेशन वाइड सत्याग्रह अगेंस्ट द प्रपोज्ड रॉलेट एक्ट दिस एक्ट वॉज पास्ड इन ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट Why Mahatma Gandhi wanted to launch this Satyagraha against proposed Rowlatt Act? Because the act had been hurriedly passed through the Imperial Legislative Council despite the united opposition of Indian members. The Indian members opposed this act, but then also the British passed this act in British Parliament. It gave the government enormous power to repress political activities and allowed detention of political prisoners without trial for 2 years. That means one who goes against the British government in India, he can be detained, he can be arrested without any trial, and he will be shunted in the jail for 2 years. No trial will be there in the court. So Mahatma Gandhi wanted non-violent disobedience, civil disobedience against such unjustful laws, which would start with Hartal on 6th April. Now here, civil means the people of India not obeying the British. How that will be executed? By Hartal, doing Hartal on April 6th. Rallies were organized in various cities, workers went on strike in railway shops, and shops closed down. Everything was shunted down, closed down. So alarmed by this popular upsurge, popular awakening of the Indian people, and scattered the lines of communication such as railways, telegraph would be disrupted. The British administration decided to clamp down on nationalists. Now what happened? The British were surprised by this. So they were disrupted the communications like telegraph, railways, and the British used force to claim down this agitations. So how they did it? They arrested the local leaders from Amritsar. Even Mahatma Gandhi was barred from entering Delhi. So on 10th April, the police in Amritsar fired upon a peaceful procession. They were working peacefully. So what did happen? It provoked widespread attack on banks. The people of India started attacking on the banks of the British post office, of the British railway station. So what did the British do? They imposed a martial law, curfew type of thing. Okay. And General Dyer took the command. Now the picture comes in. General Dyer, remember the general. Martial law was imposed. That means military law was imposed. Now what happened? So on April, infamous Jallianwala Bagh incident took place. Now who was the commander of this Jallianwala Bagh massacre? Remember, General Dyer. On that day, a large crowd gathered in enclosed ground of Jallianwala Bagh. That means from all the sides there were walls, no way to go, only one way was there. Okay. Some came to protest against the government new repressive measures. Not many of the people were related with the agitation that was taking place in other parts of Punjab. Only some people came there who were related with the agitations. Others had come to attend the annual Baisakhi fair. Remember, on the April 13, Baisakhi, that we celebrate in our region also. So being from outside the city, many villagers were unaware of this martial law. This military rule, they were not known about this. That was the stage when there was no radio, no newspaper, so people didn't know about this. So Dyer entered the area, blocked the exit points and opened fire on the crowds, killed hundreds of people. And why he did this? His object was to, he declared later, to produce a moral effect, to create in the minds of Satyagrahis a feeling of terror and awe. As this news of Jallianwala Bagh spreaded, crowds took to the street in many North Indian towns. There were strike clashes with the police and attacks on the government buildings. So how the government responded against this? The government responded with brutal repression, seeking to humiliate the terrorized people. Satyagrahis were forced to rub their nose on the ground, crawl on the street, do salute to all the sahibs. That means British officials. not Indians. People were flogged and village flogged and village were boomed. That flog means they were whipped by long whip, the chabuk type of thing, okay? And they were also bombed. Seeing this violence spread, Mahatma Gandhi called off the movement. So what happened? While the roller satyagraha had been widespread movement, but it was limited only to certain towns and cities. The movement that started by Mahatma Gandhi. The ending was Jallianwala massacre, and later due to hesitation, due to distractions, due to non-violence that took place after this. So Mahatma Gandhi withdrew this movement. Mahatma Gandhi now felt that need to launch a more broad-based movement in India. But he was certain that no such movement could be organized without bringing the Hindu and Muslim together. So how he can bring the Hindu and Muslim together and fight for the independence? One way of doing this was, he felt, was to take up the Khalifat issue. What is this Khalifat issue? We need to know this. So when the First World War ended with the defeat of Ottoman Turkey, remember, Turkey, there were rumors that harsh peace treaty was going on to be imposed on Ottoman Empire, because Ottoman Empire lost the war, First World War, and he was captured. And he was the spiritual head of the Islamic world. They are known as Khalifa. Who is the spiritual head of the Islamic world? Ottoman Empire at that period. So he was defeated in the war. So the Muslim of the world thought they would dishonor, the British will dishonor this head of the Islamic world. And Mahatma Gandhi took this as an opportunity to protest against the British. So how he did it? By uniting the Hindu and Muslim of India. So to defend this Khalifa's temporal powers, Khalifa Committee was formed in Bombay in March 1919. Young generation of Muslim leaders like Muhammad Ali, Shaukat Ali began discussing with Mahatma Gandhi about the possibility of a united mass action on this issue, united Hindu and Muslim. The Muslims were related with the Khalifa against the British, and the Hindu also supported them. So a united movement, Khilafat movement started. So Gandhiji saw this an opportunity to bring Hindus, Muslims under one umbrella for national movement. At Calcutta session of the Congress in September 1920, he convinced other leaders of the need to start a non-cooperation movement in support of Khilafat as well as for Swaraj. Swaraj here means nation.